heroic couplet. These are lines of iambic pentameter which rhyme in pairs AA, BB, CC and so on. The adjective heroic was applied in the later 17th century because of the frequent use of such couplets in heroic means epic poems and in heroic dramas. This verse form was introduced into English poetry by Geoffrey Chaucer in works like The Legend of Good Women and most of the Canterbury Tales, and has been in constant use ever since. From the age of John Dryden through that of Samuel Johnson, the heroic couplet was the predominant English measure for all the poetic kinds. It is generally considered to have been perfected by John Dryden, Alexander Pope in the Restoration Age and early 18th century respectively. Dryden and Pope used the form for their translation of the epics of Homer and Virgil. It is a traditional form for English poetry, commonly used in epic and narrative poetry. Now let's see the features of heroic couplet. 1. Stanza of two lines. Couplets having an end rhyming. These couplets rhyme. We will see an example. Written in iambic pentameter. The meter used is iambic, means unstressed syllable followed by stressed. Likewise, five such units: unstressed, stressed 1, unstressed, stressed 2, unstressed, stressed 3, unstressed, stressed 4, unstressed, stressed 5. And sometimes you can see, maybe in the first or second line, a break which is denoted by a comma called caesura. We have an example for heroic couplet from Alexander Pope's Of the Characters of Women. These are the lines. See how the world its veterans rewards, a youth of follies, an old age of cards, fair to no purpose, artful to no end, young without lovers, old without a friend. So the first two lines end with rhyme, rewards, cards. Third and four, another end friend. So we have AABB. And the second line, a youth of follies, then there's a comma. And old age of cards. So it's a pause, break in the line, caesura. Third line also, fair to no purpose, there is a break. Fourth line, young without lovers, there is a break. So these are the features of heroic couplets. We have two kinds of heroic couplets: open heroic couplets, also called riding rhyme, and closed heroic couplets. Open heroic couplets are rhyming couplets that are enjambed. Phrase not completed in the first line continues to the second also. We have an example: Heroine Leander by Christopher Marlowe. Her white sleeves green and bordered with a grove were Venus in her naked glory strove. To please the careless and disdainful eyes of proud Adonis that before her lies. So the first line continues to the second also. It's a continuation: with a grove were Venus. Third line continues in the fourth one also. Disdainful eyes of proud Adonis. So it's a continuation. First line never stops there. It moves to the second line. Likewise, third moves to the fourth line. And closed heroic couplets are rhyming couplets that are, first and foremost, syntactically discrete, meaning that each couplet is end-stopped with the end of couplet. We have example, An Essay on Criticism by Alexander Pope. A little learning is a dangerous thing. Drink deep or taste not the Pierian spring. First line ends the dangerous thing. Second line also. Third one, the shallow draughts intoxicate the brain and drinking largely sobers us again. Third line, intoxicate the brain. It is actually not continued. The concept is not continued in the fourth line like the first example. So the difference between them is just grammatical. While the closed couplet, each of the two lines is end-stopped, the open couplet would extend the meaning of the first line to the second also. This is all for now. Thank you.